Welcome to this Fourroux presentation of Advancements in Prosthetics. We've put together this special DVD for you, the case manager, to help you understand the challenges faced by prosthetic patients, as well as the latest in prosthetic care and technology. We begin with The Journey, an insightful program that includes hopeful one-on-one interviews and a unique window into patients' lives from amputation through rehabilitation and to recovery. The Journey is a great tool for helping new amputees. Next, the socket has been described as the most important part of a prosthesis. Learn the basics of lower extremity socket design, fitting, liners, socks, and more in our presentation entitled Inside the Socket. Finally, proper physical therapy is essential to an amputee's recovery. We invite you to join our staff physical therapist and see what our patients see in this excerpt from our home exercise program. Just one of the many tools we provide to help our patients achieve the freedom and independence they deserve. Welcome. Losing your limb is life-changing. For many people, dealing with an amputation seems overwhelming, not just physically, but emotionally too. It's true that this is a challenging time, but understanding the road to recovery and having the tools to do the job will put you on the right path to get back to your life. Your case manager and Fourroux Prosthetics have teamed together to bring you this program. In our care and in the future, the quality of your life is important to us. You are not alone. Our people are committed to your care and support. In the next few minutes, we'll answer a lot of your questions. We'll tell you about your next few steps, about prosthetics, and what to expect in the months and years ahead. With our dedication and your commitment, you can have the freedom and independence you deserve.
Most people never know I'm an amputee until I show it to them, because this is not something that I pattern my life around. I had a motorcycle accident. Pickup truck hit me. I remember the truck hit me. I remember looking the guy in the eyes when it happened. And it was like he just didn't see me. He was looking straight through me. I remember rolling down the side of the road and ended up setting up in a ditch. My leg was broken. It was actually turned behind me. I remember getting to the hospital. At that time, everything started kind of getting fuzzy, and I didn't really know what was happening. The next thing I know is I wake up, and it's 2 weeks later. I don't know it's 2 weeks later at the time, but I wake up. My accident happened a long ways away from home, and my parents were called when the accident happened, and I lived in a small town, and they were told that I was dead. And they drove all that way over there thinking that. And I didn't know that until this time. And they had told me, you know, everything that I'd already been through. I had 8 breaks in my femur that wouldn't heal. And as time went on, my whole body went down. My whole way of thinking got bad. I got to a point where, you know, I wanted something done. I'd hurt for so long. I wanted something to happen. My surgeon came to me and he said, we're at a point where we're going to have to do something about the infection. If we're able to save your leg, you'll be in a long leg brace and it will be locked at the knee and you'll have maybe 10% use of it. If we elect to do an amputation, you should get about 15% of it. And that was basically all anyone ever said to me about an amputation in the hospital, about nothing about prosthetics or anything. I'd been hurting for so long, my body was, I felt like I was gonna die. and I elected for the amputation. My lowest point was when I was pushed downstairs, and I actually saw myself in the middle of the night sitting in a wheelchair. And I had to start making a decision then. I was 17 years old. I was scared to death. And there was a lot of life that I still had to live. I wanted to raise a family. I wanted to enjoy life and do the things that I wanted to do, see my family grow up, my kids grow up. And it was tough. It was really tough because there was points where I didn't know if I even wanted to go on, because my whole life had changed so dramatically. So I knew at that time that I had to do something. And I kind of got out and started searching, and been on a long road. But today, it's a lot different. And I just don't want those folks to go through some of that stuff. Sorry.
Kim's story may sound like yours. You may have lost your limb in a different way, but right now, you're probably overwhelmed with questions.
How long before I'm gonna be walking again? What does it feel like? Does it hurt? No, it's not supposed to hurt. How are people gonna look at me now? What can I do? Am I gonna be able to get to doing the things that I used to do? Am I gonna be on disability? Right after my surgery, I woke up and I was kind of in a groggy feeling. And I really hadn't looked down yet. But I remember taking my foot, and this was back, there was a knob on the end of the hospital bed there. And with my foot, I reached over and I felt that knob, and I thought I was feeling my other foot. So in my mind, it was still there. It felt kind of like it was asleep. A little bit of that, it's there, I can still move it, but I can't move it. That's kind of what I felt. When I looked down and saw that it was really gone, I noticed that I could still feel my toes and my foot and my heel and my calf, my knee. I could still feel everything, but it wasn't there. And that was kind of hard to understand. You know, how could I feel something that wasn't there? A lot of different questions are normal questions.
It's important to ask your questions and have them answered. A nurse, a doctor, or an amputee counselor like Kim can guide you. It's the first step in preparing yourself for the work ahead.
Those first few days and weeks of an amputee's life is going to determine how good they become from now on.